Hello guys and welcome back to Brits Bollywood. Before the break, I asked you a question: who directed the film Andaaz Apna Apna? And the answer is Rajkumar Santoshi. You know, I love that film. I can watch it day in, day out, every day, and I still have the same laughters. You know, Gogo Master was my favorite, seriously. And Salman and Aamir Khan's comic timing, brilliant. Writing was awesome. But I've got some garam garam hubba, right? You've heard about Priyanka Chopra and Shah Rukh Khan having an affair. Okay, everyone, the whole world knows now. And here is some latest news. Apparently at the rap party, she had her hand in Shah Rukh Khan's pocket and some photographers took a picture. And next minute they were sold to a magazine, to a website, and it all blew out. And apparently at the recent trip that he did to Germany, his wife Gauri Khan accompanied him. We don't know what's going on, but apparently the whole industry is buzzing that Priyanka Chopra is being kicked out of some major A-list films because of this. Everyone from Karan Johar has just moved away from her. I hope this doesn't jeopardize her career, because we don't know what the truth is or isn't, but we wish them all the best. But right now it's time for Mr. Hotel Marigold. I'm talking about Dev Patel, so check this out. I'm here, it's sitting in a very close proximity with Dev Patel. How does that feel anyway? To be here on scene in very close proximity.
It feels so wonderful to be so close to you.
So, how are you doing today?
I'm good. It's snowing. Yeah. It's nice to be home. I flew in on Saturday from LA.
Sure.
And it was a shock to the senses to see some snow.
What's the weather like in LA?
Sunny, man. It's sunny.
We are delighted that, you know, this film is releasing now.
Thank
because
you.
We've been looking forward since Slumdog. You did a couple of films.
Yeah.
So tell us more about your role.
I play this guy called Sunny.
Sure.
And the name...
It's a very Indian name, by
yes,
the way.
Yes, yeah.
Everyone's pet name.
I know, pet name, right? Yeah. And Sunny says it all. He's like a... He's just a live wire, you know, a scatterbrain, controlled mess kind of guy who owns this hotel.
Sure.
And he cleverly uses Photoshop to rope in all these seniors to come to his old people's home.
Absolutely.
He's turned this place into a old people's home, which he calls outsourcing the elderly.
Sure.
And when they arrive, they see that all is not what it seems, and madness ensues afterwards.
Sure. So has that ever happened to you in real life, that someone's actually shown you something, maybe the picture on Facebook, probably in younger days, and you know, it just wasn't what was.
Oh, that's funny. I don't have like a. I'm so bad with Facebook and MySpace and like all that. I don't have any of that. But there must be many a times where that's happened to me. I'm so easy to punk.
Sure.
Because I'm really gullible. My sister's probably the one that does it the most, to be honest. Like, many a times, I don't know. Yeah.
So how was it working with all these legends? I think you had the best of, I mean, when I was watching the film last night, I mean, you know, we're the best of
British talent,
absolutely.
Yeah.
And it was just incredible to just see, like, so much talent in one film.
I know, they're really good, right? It was just, you know, they lead with grace. They're
sure.
Just so, so classy, man. And
sure.
To have them all in this, like, package deal for one movie is amazing. It really is. It was a privilege and... you know, it's a unique movie. I don't think anything's really been made like this before.
Absolutely.
So it's cool.
Yeah, but what if, like, you know, when the first day of the shoot, were you, like, overwhelmed? Or were you, like, did you guys have rehearsal? What was the process?
The most terrifying part was the week before I got cast. You know, just the anticipation of, what it was going to be like meeting all these people. But they're just wonderful. They're just so graceful and lovely and giving, you know.
Sure.
They really are, which is great, yeah.
So, which one was your favourite character in the film?
Favourite character? It's a hard one. It's got to be Maggie's character.
Maggie she's Smith. Hilarious.
She's rock and roll. She's a scene stealer, that's what someone said today. And, you know, I've got, like, tons of lines, and I'm talking and talking and talking.
Yeah.
I'm this big showman. And she'll just roll in on her wheelchair and say something and then roll out.
And she'll just take away the scene.
It's steal the scene. Brilliant. She's so funny, right?
Yeah, she's incredible. Tell us, like, you know, how was it going back to India now? I mean, obviously a different city. How was it different from the first experience?
Yeah, the first time, no one really knew who I was. So I was just like a skinny Indian guy running around screaming Latika in the streets. And everyone was like, who is this dude?
Yeah, yeah.
Who is this
What's
guy?
What's wrong with him?
Yeah, go back home. and then I went this time. And it's weird because people kind of knew who I was out there. And it's beautiful because they loved Slumdog, and they're really fond. You know, there's a real place in their heart for that movie.
Sure.
And there's a sense of pride.
Absolutely.
And you know, I'd get into rickshaws and things, and people would just start firing questions and talking to me, and I can't speak Indian.
Sure.
So you know, it's kind of funny. But it's wonderful, and we shot in Udaipur and Jaipur, and like Slumdog was shot in Bombay, yeah. which is full of people and crazy shock to the senses, but this was, you know, picturesque, visceral, just beautiful landscapes, you know.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Now, the story is very universal, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, Asians, especially on ZTV, saying, we have this tendency that, you know, we keep our parents close to us, like,
yes.
probably even till we are, like, 50 and have grandkids and we're still living with our parents.
Yeah, yeah,
I'm
yeah.
just saying, so how did that compare? Like, what do you think about university? How does this appeal to the Asian lot?
I think it's great, because that was a cool thing about him. Like, he didn't live with his mother.
Yeah.
And he, you know, that like, I've been sent tons of Indian
yeah.
scripts,
yeah.
and I throw half of them away because, you know, this had something which the West and people would feel very, which they would know would be familiar to an
sure.
Indian, you know, it's like very like that, but he had cool aspects, like he talked about sex,
yeah.
and he wanted he had a girlfriend,
course, yeah, yeah, yeah.
and he rode a motorcycle,
absolutely.
But he still had that kind of Bollywood flamboyance
yeah.
in the way he dressed.
He dressed.
But yeah, you know, he didn't live with his mother, and he wanted to be free, and he was kind of like a mini entrepreneur, just a bit too daft at times.
So if I get busted, if I use your methods to like sneak in a girl,
yeah.
can I just completely blame it on you?
You can, man.
Seriously, have
it.
You ever done that? Let's hear this.
What?
asking your girl to sneak in.
I've done some pretty mad things in skin days. When I was doing skins. Shiggle, wow! we won't take it there.
We're not going to go there. So, any special message to the audience about this film that you'd like to share?
Please see it, man. It's different. It's a really unique movie. I think if this is for Asian audiences, it's a movie that they should be proud of because it talks about
India. It has Dev in it.
Yeah. Oh, no, not because of that. But
and that.
The country is like a really big character in the movie. And
sure.
It changes lots of people's yeah. perspectives. Like, you have some characters that love India. You have some characters that hate the very thought of it. And the country changes them, you know. And you know, it's not the cliche people dancing around trees and stuff.
Sure, sure.
It's funny and cool, and you know.
Well, here's the best part, guys. Before we go away, just to let you know, Dev, his entry scene with the lady, leading lady, that was very Bollywoodish for what you did with the girl when she jumped straight on you on the motorbike.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah. So we're not gonna reveal now. But seriously, if you're talking about Bollywood, that was pure Bollywood senses.
No, except for what happened afterwards on the bike.
Well, anyway, it was a great pleasure being here.
Thank you.
I hope, you know, we wish the film all the success, and
thanks,
it was a pleasure.
Thank
you so much. Cheers.
Have a good one.
Thank you.
Welcome to the best exotic marigold hotel.
I'm here with a lovely Tina. She flew all the way from India to promote a film. So tell us more about yourself, and obviously this is your debut film.
In English.
In English.
I've done two Hindi films.
Two Hindi films, but
yes.
This is your debut film. And are you from Bombay?
I'm from Bangalore.
You're from Bangalore.
I moved to Bombay for work
sure.
recently, yeah.
And so how did this film happen?
Auditions, many, many rounds of them.
How many? Let's give us.
Three, no, okay.
I'm sorry, it was something like those Bollywood auditions that are
yeah.
like 100,000, no.
Yeah, no, actually this was the longest...
process.
Yeah, because I've only had like two before this. This was three and plus a look at the work profile after that.
Sure.
So, I mean, I know the casting director's ahead, so I had one round with her, the second was with John in a few days, and then after a few weeks there was a third round where I had to do all of my scenes with
sure.
him. And then finally I got it.
How was anticipation waiting for to hear from them?
It was impossible. It was ridiculous. I mean, when I went in for the first round, it was great because
yeah.
I was like, I didn't know anything about
sure.
the film. The first round, they don't give you any
information.
Yeah. So I didn't know anything about the makers, nothing.
You didn't know who the director was?
I didn't know who the director
wow.
was. I
okay.
didn't know what the cast was. It
sure.
could have been a Hindi film,
for
as
Ed,
an Indian
yeah,
filmmaker
yeah,
making
yeah,
an English
yeah.
film. I don't know. And then after the audition, I looked around and there were like pictures of all the actors up on the walls, and that's when I realized that this was the film. And I was like, "Sahel, these are the actors of the film." She was like, "Yeah, that's why we have it up." And I was like, "Damn it!" After that, it was just very, very difficult to wait because obviously, when you're that excited,
yeah, sure.
then suddenly you really want something.
Sure.
So I was like, "Okay, you audition me, but then you know, you give me an answer really quickly. I can't wait." But finally, after I think a month, because three
sure.
rounds happened,
sure.
I kind of got the part.
So obviously this is a very special film with so much of British talent and
yes.
it was legendary. Let's say for sake of argument, you were a daredevil character in the film.
Yeah.
Especially when you sneak to meet your boyfriend.
yeah.
Have you ever done that in real life?
No, but I think it's the good part
what
about
kind of
film. You get to
is
do,
that? Yeah.
You get to do all the crazy things that you wouldn't do in real life and get away with it. It's great fun.
Yeah, but
I won't have the guts.
You won't have the guts.
Well, no, it's...
That's the actually mother's how supposed to be around.
Yeah, imagine sneaking in. I have some guts. I like Sunena.
But you know, in Bombay, like, everyone's become like quite open now. You know, people are having live-in relationships. People are living in together. Yeah. So it's quite open. Apart from when you have to rent a house in a society, that's when they give you, massive grief.
Yeah.
But how does that compare? Is this the woman of India today? This character?
Definitely, for various reasons. One is, you know, I think every youngster in India right now is very clearly focused on career,
sure.
has a mind of their own, you know, is living independently, doing their own thing,
sure.
but is still at the same time the support of their guy or whatever, is still tolerant towards old-fashioned people, is still respectful to the elders.
Sure.
So their roots are still there, their culture is still there,
sure.
but they're also, you know,
absolutely.
Becoming independent. And,
sure.
Yeah.
Sure. How do you think the Desi audience will, you know, relate to this film?
I was thinking about that. What happens in the film is it's very clearly someone experiencing India for the first time. You know, so they come in not able to. It's a slight culture shock. So the colors and the sound and the traffic and all of that happens. But then they slowly, you know, give in and accept India as it is. So I think people will like that because they're embracing the culture.
Sure.
You know, there's only one character that doesn't like. You know, so I think. If you do show that you like the country, people will like it because it is a very true portrayal of how things are there. So.
Well, we wish you all the best at Brits Bollywood, Tina. So good luck, and I hope it goes well.
Thank you.
Pleasure, absolutely.
Thank you.
In the sky.
Everything will be all right in the end. So if it is not all right, it is not yet the end. It's just you.